Mr. Speaker, the killing is a Boko Haram style. Shot sporadically at every bureau they saw. In fact, I will give an example in my own case. They completely sacked my official residence, shot through the windows.
That matter of urgent public importance by the member representing Onwa East constituency, Foley Ogedegbe, condemning the Saturday's attack on Legislators Quarters, prompted the lawmakers to recount their ordeal, heaping the blame on the Edo State Police Command and the opposition party.
Mr. Speaker, I think the petition should go beyond the Commissioner of the Inspector General of Police. The petition should go to the Director of SSS, the Military Formation, and Mr. President. Because, Mr. Speaker, this is how Boko Haram started.
Till this time, nobody has been arrested. As we speak, my dear colleagues, they have plugged everything out. ESCC right now is on some member of this house. I am aware, rely on me, that Mr. Speaker already has the letter, the majority leader already has the letter, the chief whip already has the letter.
I just want to use this opportunity to talk to those youths who allow themselves to be used.
When constitutionally a police force that is duty bound to protect life and property eventually became a major participant in the macabre operation that happened, there is no way we can close our eyes to that.
The Speaker of the APC House, Uyihigbe, said the Directorate of the State Security Services should investigate the role of the police as well as fish out those behind the attack for possible prosecution. He said the decision to invite the SSS into the matter is based on the fact that the House no longer has confidence in the police.
I think what is more worrisome is the fact that the police were aware that this attack would take place. And rather than beefing up security, they actually withdrew security and left only one policeman there. So it shows the police complicity in this attack. One wonders, when you write a petition to the police, are we not wasting our time?
In a previous interview, the PDP leaders in Edo State have denied any involvement in the attack on the lawmakers and urged the APC and its leadership to search inwards.
Members of our party have nothing to do with what happened at the legislative quarters of the State House of Assembly. I understand and I believe that those who came out this morning addressed the press, and the leadership of that body stated clearly that they were concerned Edo State youths.
In the resolution, the APC House also urged the federal government to check the activities of the Edo PDP. Copies of the resolution are to be forwarded to the Presidency, Office of the Governor, National Security Advisor, Inspector General Police, Edo State Police Command, AIG Zone 5, and the Directorate of State Security Services, as well as the Palace of the Benin Monarch. The House later adjourned till Monday, the 20th of October. Christy Macaulay reporting.